know, hearing Law's conversation, I thought I was doing well, doing eight figures, multi eight figures, and I'm thinking to myself, this guy's doing eight figures, nine figures in his sleep. But you know, the first thing is he's giving all credit and praise to God, the Almighty, which is, you know, for me, super important because I believe everything comes from God. Secondly, just his humbleness and humility, right? Like, first time when I met him, I was like thinking, he's got a lot of rings and a lot of diamonds. But then as he started speaking, I realized, wow, this is a cool, humble guy. I'm just gonna sit, shut up, and listen and learn. And then there's another guy that came in, and they started talking, and I thought, you know what, when I find people like this, I don't need to talk. What I need to do is just listen, soak in that energy, that vibe, that frequency, and tap into it. And even just one of the things he said was removing yourself, trading time for money. So for in my business, I get paid a lot for being a highly paid expert. I just got paid 50 grand. I just got paid 100 grand for consulting. But then he's like, he wants to be a good husband, a good father. And I'm like, dang, I need to step up in that area, right? And so for me, like having small little shifts like that, it doesn't matter how much you get paid. You can get paid 100 grand from a single client, but you're still trading time for money. That for some reason just like hit me. So I know some of the changes I'm gonna be making to nine figures. Let's go, Law.
We gotta stop thinking that anything in the dark is bad, or you can't be terrified to step into the darkness, because when you step back out, it might be something way better than when it that went in. I know that was the case for me, and I can only speak on it for me, but I have seen it several times in other places. You know what I mean? I was growing plants, and I just started this gig, and Law was with me. We was looking to invest, and you would have to require these plants would have to have a certain amount of no sunlight, not a drop of light in the room. If it did, it impaired their growth. So they had to be set on certain timers from the light, but for a period, they had to be in the darkness. And then when that light came on, you could see their development, I promise you, overnight. Something happened overnight in the darkness. You know, so it's just as much as about deprogramming your mind and reprogramming it, because we gotta be solution-based thinkers. You know what I mean? If sometimes we overcomplicate things and we don't look for the solution. And if we're not looking for a solution, we just going in a circle and making more problems for ourselves. Selling out currently, I'm unstoppable, niggas can't guard me. Go up top, I'm too rich to be arguing. I've been chilling, I hope you ain't thinking I lost it. I gave me salaries, I'm on that ball shit. Don't play no ball, when you play, we gon' cross it. She wanna fuck with the kid, cause I'm saucy. If you wanna write, when you know it's gon' cost you, I do it. Something about click funnels just gets me going. I'm ready to go, let's go. Play games, I'm not that petty. Full court press, I'm not gon' let up. I don't care, I guess I'm fed up. I'm doing good, but could be better. I don't talk much, but I ain't. Shut up. What's up, everybody? It's day one of Funnel Hacking Live. It is gonna be an amazing day. We have so many guest speakers who are gonna be dropping so much information and gems. You guys gotta stay tuned. This is where all the energy is for you to be propelled in life. You have to be here. And if you can't be here, be sure to tune into the video. Let's go.
That's funny, we were just talking. My homegirl right there, she just mentioned your name, and I just see you walk. I'm like, look, this is Quincy. She said she wanted to ask you a question. I'm gonna make sure. She said she was going to look for you because she had to ask you a specific question. I think Neo told her to come to you and ask you a specific question. So, look at, what's we just talking about?
What? We saw you speak at in Atlanta at Neo Pastor. My wife is in LA. Nice to meet you. Yes, and you're in Kansas City, right? I'm in Nebraska. But we were talking about, or Neo told me that anytime I see you that I should ask you about white labeling. Because you know in Atlanta how you were like, I have like 4,000 ebooks that I white label. So I went to Harvard and I have like this amazing course that I want to white label, because at this point I license it to banks and universities. And it's like, I'm still wondering, should I label it, white label it or not? And Neil was like, you need to talk to Lil Payne.
It's worth it. I would try it.
Is it worth it?
I would try it. And what do you have to lose?
Okay.
White label it. I think a lot of people would love to make it.
But it's like, honestly, considering it's like, I only have a licensing program, and then it's like, I don't want to bring down the credibility of it. It's like working with like Juilliard, Rutgers, banks, right? But now I like want to bring it to the entrepreneurship world, because it's like I want to teach them how to Mac. It's literally like a business Bible, and that anyone can use it. You know, like the information is not mine to hold. And the fact that they can now go use it, and I license it to universities. But then once that license expires, and they always, you know, come back and like renew it. But now I'm like, maybe I should just white label it for even entrepreneurship, you know?
I would.
You would?
Yeah.
But it's like, do you go through a publisher? It's like that white label.
Self-published.
What?
Self-published.
Self-published?
Yeah, absolutely. Why would you?
Should I put my face on it? Because this company that I have, it's a faceless brand. Like, I don't have, it's like, I never put like my
you
face
brand
on it.
Are you scared?
No.
I was like that.
No. But it's like I always had this as a faceless brand, like this whole Excel boost. Like, you know, we're working with like at this point Juilliard, Rutgers, all these big banks. But it's like when I show up, I'm still showing up as an employee, even though it's like my company. But it's like now if you want to white label it, should I say like, oh, like I'm the one who created the course?
It'll sell better.
Really?
Have a score.
So you're saying I should self-publish it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because the whole purpose of it is to honestly just impact people. That's literally what's it like. That's literally the whole purpose I want to do it. Like, there's so many people trying to figure out like the affiliate marketing, things like that. And then now that I found all these resources to maximize it, I just want to do it. You know?
That alone will get you more stuff.
Yeah. And then when you were speaking in Atlanta and you were mastermind, you know, you logged in your ClickFunnels and I was like, with white labeling, really? And I asked Neil.
Oh, my sales aren't even really on
it. Exactly, that's what Neil was saying. I told him, I was like, does Mark, does he own PLR Hustle? He was like, I don't know. I'm going to ask him that.
Yeah, we're going to do probably half a billion this year. Or in 4X.
So. Oh, you see, y'all going crazy right now.
Yeah,
I'm already knowing. So I think right now, at the end of the year, you need to be thinking about what you can do, what strategies you can employ to get that money to not be taxable, right? Because this is active trading, you're paying ordinary income taxes because it's trading in an active account. So you need to be thinking about what strategies, what things can you employ to minimize the tax, or at least buy you more time so that you can keep that money tax-free. The thing with day trading is you're paying ordinary income taxes, and that's at 37% for you. So you want to make sure you're employing strategies before December 31st to make sure you keep all that money.
So I'm saying I need to buy a lot of real estate.
That's it. Buy real estate, do a cost segregation study, push that depreciation up until this year so that you don't have to worry about paying taxes on the majority of that money. And if you buy a property, Airbnb it, and you can do a cost seg on it, and then that'll kill most of that income.
Yeah, that's kind of what we're doing right
now. Okay, then you're a good hit. You're a good hit. I don't think it's too much of your time, brother. Save some muscles for the rest of us, that's all I'm saying. Come on, man. No, that's all you, man.
God, thank you so much for honestly the freedom and the blessing to be able to stand in a room gathered together and talk about you and how much we love you. And to know and to feel how much you love us, God. Thank you for bringing this all to this event together so we can look into people's eyes, for goodness sakes. I'm so excited about being able to be with people because we know that you created us for the purpose of relationship. And face-to-face, you know, person-to-person relationship is so incredibly powerful. I pray, God, that you do bring the right people to us in every conversation and every moment of this entire week, that we are lifting others, that while you are lifting us, that the things that we're hearing and learning bless our businesses, bless the people that we serve, that the people that we're interacting with, that we're able to bless them, that they honestly, that they can continue to bless us as well. I just pray blessing on this entire week.
Yes, yes, Lord. I pray, Father God, that you remind us that we're here to serve. Amen. I pray, Father God, that you remind us that we're here looking for those that are lost. As much as there's 99 of us here, metaphorically, Lord, we're looking for that lost sheep, Lord, and that's ultimately what you're here for, Lord. So we ask you, Father God, that you help us be the right lighthouse, if so be it, where people can look up to us, and not because of who we are, but who we are in you, Lord. Lord, I just pray for everyone here that are with us now, Lord God, and everyone that's in that room over there, Lord Jesus. I pray for all the speakers and all the staff of this event, Lord God. And I pray that it would be a God-glorifying event, Lord God. I pray that you would make awesome connections, Lord God. Everyone's looking for strategic partnerships in here for their business growth and everything like that, Lord God. And they have lanyards, Lord Jesus, and awards and all these different things that elevate their position in the business world, Lord God. We know that there are some here and some in that room, Lord God, that we're going to have just the biggest mansions in heaven, Lord Jesus, for how much they serve you, Father. And God, I just pray that you would ignite a fire in all of us, Lord God, that we would, as we're continuing to grow and build our businesses and everything like that, Lord Jesus, we use it for your kingdom and your glory in your name's sake, Lord Jesus. I pray that you would make those awesome connections in the midst of all this, Lord God, that we could have the opportunities to meet people, be the first person to introduce Jesus to somebody here at this event, Lord God. We love you, Lord. We thank you, God, for every blessing. It's in your beautiful, holy, and precious name that I pray.
Amen. We don't have enough champions, so I look at it like somebody has to be the champion, because in our field, we're either an athlete, rapper,
drug dealer,
or drug dealer. So those are your options to really see the type of success that somebody like me have seen. So if more people are sharing, like at ClickFunnels, where lots of people are building million-dollar businesses, and you share that in a positive way, very humble, that's going to give people more options.
What's up, brother? How you doing?
Shaqir Hussyin, nice to meet you, brother.
You too, man.
Good to see you.
Real pleasure. I see all the ads online.
Yeah. I see you crushing it.
Yeah. How you doing?
Guys? Are these all your guys?
Yeah, this is all my video guys.
Nice.
Is it cool?
Yeah, of course, bro. Of course.
Okay.
What's up, yo?
Yeah, why don't you introduce yourself, because my audience doesn't really know
who
you are.
Hey everyone, my name is Shaqir Hussyin, founder of funnels.com, and we're here at the Funnel Hacking Live 2022 event.
Let's get it. If you're not here, you're missing out.
Nice.
What's your biggest challenge right now? What are you looking to accomplish?
Time.
Time? Okay.
Yeah, that's me.
Cool, man.
Yeah, just time, man. Just making sure I can stay balanced, stay on track for the goals that I set for myself.
Yeah, I mean, do you?
Trying to hit a trillion.
A trillion? Oh, yeah, trillion. Let's go.
Yeah, and then promote it, get other people to believe that they can do it too.
Oh yeah,
that's cool.
Staying motivated, trying to, hit goals, come meet like-minded people, and just staying in the moment, trying to be present.
Yeah, that's awesome. Man. How many kids do you have?
Twins.
Twins. Yeah. How old?
2-year-olds.
Nice, dude. Yeah. Congrats.
Actually, our kids were born like 7 days apart.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy. Yeah. Congrats, man.
Yeah, it's crazy how God works, man. Because I prayed about having kids for over a decade. And
oh, really? Me too, man. I'm still praying. I haven't had kids yet.
Oh, it'll happen.
Yeah.
It'll happen.
Yeah.
Stay faithful.
Yeah.
I know towards the end, right before we actually found out that we were pregnant, like my faith was wavering. Like it was, man, because we was 10 years into it.
Oh, wow.
The reason I was so motivated to make money is because, dude, I spent like $1 million. Like going to doctors and IVF, but, I was relentless.
Wow. With, you know, my pursuit to try to make my wife's and I's goal happen.
Wow.
So I couldn't help but run, go after these goals.
Wow.
So now that we got the kids, it like went up times 100.
Yeah.
Because now I'm on generational wealth type stuff. And got big goals to, you know, inspire a culture and a generation at the same time.
Be some 25 and you broke. Talking about me on the internet, but you dapped me up when we spoke. I don't know if I'm genius, but I definitely had a few strokes. Real raps, not jokes. Dressed like I'm at Oaks. Ayy, Sears sucking my coat. Daycare in her throat. Hit songs in my notes. Hit notes like don't. I just got in my zone. Had to let it be known. Brought her out, she got flown. Unspoken, we bone. Fell in love with my tone.
I can't believe it's been a year since we were hanging out. Welcome back, you guys. How y'all feeling today?
I'm gonna stand up, put our hands together for Jordan Burroughs.
It's so good to be here. It's so good to be here.
So can I let you guys in on a secret?
Yeah.
This is a secret. I'm actually kind of embarrassed to say this. I've never had a job before. I'm 34 years old and I've never worked a single day in my life. Which is, I don't know if that's something to brag about, actually, because I'm trying to get my kids to work hard and go to school and they're like, Dad, you never worked before. What are you talking about? And so, as I go through this process of life, I started to understand that I had the ability to control my own destiny, because if I had to apply for a job, number one, I've got no resume. Wouldn't even know how to write a resume. Number two, I've got no expertise in business, no digital marketing skills, no online marketing skills, but what I do know is I know how to win. I know how to win.
Let's go, love!